Hey everyone, so you've bought some cheap ass RAM which doesn't have a heatsink, and now you want to overclock this 5000 MHz RAM stick into an 8000 MHz monster. Is that actually possible? Is that a good idea? Well, firstly, it's not possible, but if you were actually wanting to try something like that, like overclocking 5600 MHz RAM into 6000 MHz, you probably don't want to do it if you have just the bare RAM stick with no heatsink at all. And the first reason for that is that when you're overclocking especially, heat ramps up almost exponentially. So if you've got a bare RAM stick like this one that doesn't have any sort of heatsink, then actually you probably don't want to overclock it or attempt overclocking without any level of heatsink, especially because too much heat can lead to data corruption. So you could find that if you're overclocking, it might seem stable at first, but actually if it doesn't have a heatsink whatsoever, then your RAM stick will begin too hot and not be able to dissipate that heat as well. And then actually you could have more data corruption, which could lead to lost data, or you know, your programs crashing, or blue screen of death, or entire system shutdowns, or your system will simply thermal throttle, or your RAM will, which then defeats the object of trying to overclock it because it'll be running slower than if you hadn't attempted overclocking to begin with. The next thing I'd say is if you don't have a heatsink on your RAM, usually RAM is located in a bit of your system that doesn't have as much airflow. So some of the air coming in will cool your CPU, and then some of it will go into your GPU and be exhausted out, but often you don't get heat or the cooling performance of your fans going too near the RAM sticks, and that is a bit of a flaw if you wanted to overclock, and especially if you don't have any heatsink. So what should you actually do? Well, the answer is probably obvious, but you should buy some sort of heatsink. So if you're going to overclock and push your system quite a lot, you're probably going to want to buy a RAM stick in advance with a heatsink. But if you don't have that, you can buy third-party heatsinks, just like you can get them for NVMe drives, you can get them from your RAM as well. And I would definitely recommend doing that before actually trying to overclock, because yeah, doing it on this would be a bit of a problem. But hopefully that all makes sense. If you've got any questions though, please drop me a comment. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.